Hello students, so today we will discuss some problems on gravitation chapter. Okay, so this is our first problem and this is based on the forces between two masses, or we can say on gravitation law. So according to this question, four point masses are revolving in a circle. They are orbiting in a circle, and the radius is r, and they are moving in a circle because of the mutual gravitation attraction force. Okay, so here they are asking what will be the orbiting speed. So we know that if this mass is rotating in a circle, so this require a centripetal force, and that centripetal force should be toward the center, and this should also require a centripetal force that should be toward the center. Okay, and here the centripetal force is provided by the gravitation force. So let's calculate what is the net force acting on this. Due to symmetry, we can say all are having same forces, all are having same net resultant force toward the center, means magnitude is same. Okay, so let's say this M mass is experiencing one force due to this M mass. So this is experiencing one force due to this, and this is also experiencing due to this, and so this is third force. So this mass is experiencing 1, 2, and 3 force. So this will be the second force due to this. So we can say this is experiencing 3 forces. From symmetry we can say if this is F1, so this will be F2, and this is also F2 because of symmetry. And also we can say they are forming a right angled triangle. So this is equal to r radius, this is equal to r, and this is a right angle triangle, so this angle will be what, 45 degree. So this theta, so we can calculate 10 theta is equal to perpendicular by base. So perpendicular is this r and base is this r. So here it is equal to 1, so we can say theta is equal to 45 degree. Now let's calculate what is this F1 force. So the distance between the two masses is r and r, 2r. So the value of F1 force will be g m1 into m2, means m square by distance is 2r whole square. So this will be g m square by 4r square. Now let us calculate the value of F2. So see, from the right angle triangle we can say this is r, this is r, so this will be root 2r. So by applying Pythagoras theorem, r square plus r square and under root of r square plus r square, this will give root 2r. So this F2 will be equal to g m1 m, m2 is also m, so g m square by root 2 r whole square. So this will be g m square by 2 r square. So for example, suppose we are considering this as, let's say, x. So this will be r twice of x. So the net force on this M will be what? The resultant of F1 and F2 and F2. So that will be the net force on this mass, and that net force will provide the centripetal force. So let's calculate what is the resultant force. So So here we know that this is our f1. F1 means x, here x, and here 2x, and here 2x. And the angle is 45. So the component of this force 2x here will be 2x cos 45 and here 2x sin 45. So the component of this force, so here I am writing x is there, and the component of this 2x, here 2x cos 45 and here 2x sin 45. So it is 2x cos 45 and here in vertical direction 2x sin 45. Similarly, due to this, this is the angle also 45. So 2x cos 45 is here and 2x sin 45 in downward direction. So here it is 2x cos 45 and 2x sin 45. So this vertical component will cancel out. So net resultant force will be in this direction, that is x plus 2 times of 2x cos 45. So what is cos 45? 1 by root 2. So this will be what? This will be equal to x plus 2 root 2 x. So take x common, 1 plus 2 root 2. Now we can substitute the value of x, that will be g m square 1 plus 2 root 2 by 4. See, this is r square, 4 r square. So this is our net force acting on this mass, the same net force, this is acting on this and acting on this also, so toward the center. So this net force will provide the required centripetal force. So suppose if it is moving with velocity v or speed v, so it requires centripetal force mv square by r, and this mv square by r will be equal to this. So again we can write mv square by r will be equal to the resultant force g m square 1 plus 2 root 2 by 4 r square. So this cancel this m. So on solving you will get v is equal to under root of g m by 1 plus 2 root 2 by 4. Here r also there. So this will be the orbital velocity. So this option is correct. Okay, so if you have any doubt you can comment also. So now we'll discuss the second problem. So our next question is, two blocks of mass m each are hung from a balance as shown in figure. As is this m and this m. The scale pan A is at a height h1, see, and whereas the pan B is at height h2. Net torque of weight acting on the system about point C will be what? So we know that torque is equal to magnitude, that is R F sine theta. So here one force that is acting, that is M G, and here again M G, and this about point C, this force is applying torque, this is R and this is F. So R is this, F is in downward direction, angle between the radius vector and force is 90 degree. So the torque will be what? This anti-clockwise, and due to this torque will be clockwise. So if masses is same, then force is same and distance r is equal to l by 2 for l, for this case and for this case l by 2. So distance r is same, force is same, theta is 90 for both the cases, but the both the torque are opposite, so net torque they will cancel out. But the thing is, here the value of g is not same. Why? Because this pen is at a height h1 and this is at a height h2, so this g will not be same. But suppose in question they are saying gravity is same, then the torque will be zero because both torque are equal and opposite, so they will cancel out. But according to this question, the zero option is not given. It means we have to consider the height also. Okay, so now what is the gravity at a height h? So that is, we know that the acceleration due to gravity at a height h, gh, equal to g 1 minus 2h by re. So this is the acceleration due to gravity at a height h. So what will be the value of g here? So here we can see this mg force is mg 1 minus 2h1 by r, and this will be what, mg 1 minus 2h2 by r, or simply we can say r, because in this question actually it is given as r. Okay, so now let us consider which is greater height, h1. So h1 is greater, it means here the gravity will be less, so this force is greater, so this torque is greater. So let us consider this clockwise torque is tau 2 and this clock this anti-clockwise torque is tau 1. So net torque will be tau 2 minus tau 1. So this is what, clockwise torque, and this is anti-clockwise torque, but this is greater, so net torque will be what, this anti-clockwise minus clockwise is anti-clockwise, so this will rotate like this. So now what is the tau 1? So torque, we know that Rf sin theta, Rf sin theta, theta in both the cases is 90. So let us substitute the value. So R is what? Here R is what, L by 2, and here also R is equal to L by 2. So L by 2 M G 1 minus 2 H2 by R sin 90, sin 90 is 1, R F sin 90, tau second tau 1 L by 2 mg 1 minus 2h1 by r. Now we will take common mg L by 2 common, we will get 1 minus 2h2 by r minus 1 plus 2h by r, 2h1 by r, so this cancel. So you can take 2h by r common, so finally you will get net torque is equal to m g l by 2, take 2 common, 2 by r common, so here h2 minus h1. So here the torque is coming because h1 is greater, so h1 is greater, but here you are getting h2 minus h1, so this torque is negative. It means we have considered the torque as anti-clockwise, but it will come as opposite of our convention. See here, this will be 2 to cancel, so mgl, mg
MGL by R into. So MGL, so you can see this option is correct. Okay, so now we'll discuss our next question. So in this question we have three particles P, Q, R, and they are placed as shown in figure P, and this is Q, this is R, and the masses of this are √3m, which is provided √3m, √3m and m. So the gravitation force on fourth particle S of mass m equal to. Okay, so here we have to calculate what is the net force acting on this. And this distance is also given, this is 3d, this is d, this is √2d. So first of all we will calculate what is the distance. So by using the Pythagoras theorem, this is what 3d, so 3d square is 9d square, and this is what √3, so 3d 12. So this will be what, under root of 12d square. So 12 will be what, 4 into 3, so 2 root 3 d. So this length is 2 root 3d, and this will be what, 2d. So now you know what is the distance. So this S is experiencing three forces. One due to this P in this direction, attraction force, and due to this Q in downward direction, and due to this R in downward direction. So this S is experiencing 1, 2, 3 forces. So the net force on this S will be the resultant of this F1, F2 and F3. Then we'll take the component also. So let's calculate what is the value. So let us consider this force as F1. This force is F2 downward, and this is F3. Okay, so let us calculate what is the value of F1, F2 and F3. F1 G √3m into m. So this will be what, √3m square. √3m square. And distance is what? We have calculated this 9 and 3, so 12. This 12, correct. So this you will get, squaring of this you will get again 12d square. Now what is the value of F2? G √3m square by 3d square. And F3 will be G m square by 4d square. So now we have calculated all the three forces. Okay, so now what we have to do is we have to take component. So how we will take the component? So we will not take the component of this force. So let assume this is as x direction, and this is as, now you know that this is x direction and this is y direction. So this force F2 is already in y direction, but these this F1 and F3 is in oblique direction. So we'll take the component of this F1 and this F3. So let's say take this as F angle theta 1. So the component of this F1 will be here, F1 cos theta 1, and in downward direction the component will be what, F1 sin theta 1. F1 sin theta 1. And the component of this, let's say this is theta 2. So this is our F3. So component of F3 here will be F3 cos theta 2, and in downward direction, so this will be F3 sin theta 2. So downward force is, in downward direction we have F2 plus F1 sin theta 1 plus F3 sin theta 2, while along x direction we have F3 cos theta 2 here and F1 cos theta 1 here. So now we have to check what is the value of theta 1 and F1. F1, F2 we already know what is the value. So from the alternate we can say this is theta, so this is also theta 1. So we need cos theta and sin theta value. So cos theta is what? Base upon hypotenuse. So cos theta, we can calculate cos theta 1 base upon hypotenuse. So base is, in this case, is this is perpendicular and this is hypotenuse. So cos theta 1 is AD and hypotenuse is root 12 d square, means 2 root 3 d square, sorry, 2 root 3 d. So you will get root 3 by 2. So we know that it means theta 1 is what, here 30 degree, because cos 60 is 1 by 2, cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So now let's calculate theta 2 also. So this will be theta 2. So first of all, let us calculate cos theta 2. So base upon hypotenuse. So base will be this and hypotenuse this. So base is B and hypotenuse is 2D. So this is what, 1 by 2. So theta 2 is what, 60 degree. So now we'll check the what is the value of this whole F3 cos F1 cos theta 1, and what is the net value of F3 cos theta 2. So F1 is root 3 g m square by 12 d square into cos theta 1. Cos theta 1 is what? Cos theta 1 is root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2. So this will be what? 3 to 3, 4. So this will be 8g m square by 8d square. This is the value of F1, F1 cos theta 1. Now we'll calculate the value of F3 cos theta 2. So F3 is g m square by 4d square into cos theta 2. Cos theta 2 is what, 1 by 2. So see, both here F1 cos theta 1 and F3 cos theta 2, both are opposite, but they are in same, they have same magnitude, so they will cancel out. So net force will be in downward direction only, and that will be what, F2 plus F1 sin theta 1 plus F3. So we can calculate what is the net force here. F net is in downward direction, and that is F2 plus F1 sin theta 1 plus F3 sin theta 2. So F2 is root 3 g m square by 3d square. F1 is root 3 g m square by 12d square into sin theta 1. Theta 1 is 30 degree and sin theta 1 will be 1 by 2, plus F3. F3 is g m square by 4d square, and theta 2, theta 2 is 60 degree, so sin 60 is root 3 by 2. So here this will be what, root 3d square, and this we can take LCM. So LCM will be what here, 24 d square. So this will be, take gm square common, so 8 root 3 here, and here root 3 only, and here 8 3 root 3. So this is what, 12 root 3. So this is gm square 12 root 3 by 24 d square. So this will be what, from solving you will get final value as g m square root 3 by 2 d square, and this force is in downward direction. So this is the net force acting in downward direction. So which option is correct? So SQ is in, see, this direction downward. So this will be correct, root 3 g m square by 2 d square in SQ direction only. So net force will be in downward direction. Understood? Okay. So now we'll move to the next question. So next question is, three identical stars of mass m are located at the vertices of a equilateral triangle of side l. The speed at which they will move if they all revolve under the influence of one another's gravitational force in a circular orbit. So here this is the same question just we discussed this problem before this. So first of all we draw a triangle, equilateral triangle actually. Let's say we have three masses M. So all are identical, so they will experience force, net force toward the center. So this is experiencing actually two forces, one F due to this and another F. So this is experiencing two force, one here, this is also experiencing two force. So we can calculate also, let's say the length is L. So now what they are asking? The speed, we have to calculate the speed at which they are revolving. So first of all we will calculate what is the net force acting on the star. So for that we will calculate first F, that is g m square by l square. So both F1 and F2 is same here, and angle is 60 degree, because this is the equilateral angle. So we know that resultant of two vector, resultant r is equal to under root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. So here let us consider this F and F in this, we can say F square plus F square plus 2F square cos 60. So this will be what, root 3F. So net force on every star will be root 3 G M square by 2L square. This will be the net force. But here every star will revolve in a circle orbit, in a circle with a radius this. So this will rotate about this centroid. So we have to calculate what is this distance. So how to calculate this distance means this distance we have to calculate. So in equilateral triangle, this distance, this and this are same. So we'll calculate. So let's draw this. This is will be a right angle triangle. So if this is L, so this is 60 degree. So this is L cos 60. This is L sin 60. This height is L sin 60. Is root 3 L by 2. And here you should remember this distance and this are in ratio of 2:1. So this length is 2/3 of the total length. So this R, you can say R, in which they are revolving, is 2/3 of this length L sin 60. So this will be what? 2/3 root 3 L by 2. This cancel this. So this will be L by root 3. So here it requires the centripetal force, that is mv square by r. So required centripetal force mv square by r, that is L by root 3, will be equal to the net resultant force, that is root 3 g m square by 2 L square. So here this will also cancel because this is coming up. Root 3 cancel. Yes. So on solving, we'll get V will be equal to under root of G M by 2 L. So this is the orbital velocity by which these star are revolving in a circle. Okay. So G M by 2 L. So G M by 2 L. So we have just done a mistake actually. Mistake is this. Actually, F is this. So there is no 2. There is no 2. So G M by this will be the answer. We have this is root 3 f and f is this f is this. So this will be the correct answer, gm by f.